Hello, fellow villagers. This is Lily Saint Christopher of the College Bound Village, and I am excited. I had a really wonderful day today. We had a scholarship Saturday, and we were able to share information with parents of college-bound students, and they were able to get money. Get ready to get their money for college. So the purpose of this particular live is that I want to talk to you about the FAFSA. And if you don't know what that stands for, it's the Free Application for Federal Student Aid, which we call the FAFSA. And the FAFSA, as of October 1st, was available for you to complete. And so it is one of those things that everybody has to complete. If you have a college student, a current college student, or if you have a high school senior, they need to complete the FAFSA. And so my son, for example, is a college sophomore. He got a full ride scholarship. It's a merit scholarship, but he needs to complete the FAFSA. And so I just completed ours on the first day of October. We're done. And I want to encourage every parent who has a college student to complete theirs. So if you complete the FAFSA, then you and your student's name will be entered into a drawing to win a free a $25 Amazon gift card. So the only thing you need to do to be eligible is to subscribe to our channel, the College Bound Village here, to go ahead and ring that bell so that whenever we post a video or go live, you'll get a notification. Go ahead and like this video and leave a comment in this particular video just to say I've done my FAFSA. If you leave a comment that says I'm completing my FAFSA, then you will be eligible and I will go back on live when we do the drawing. So we're going to do the drawing on October 28, 2020. And it's going to be during a CBV, a College Bound Village Spirit Day, which is going to be between 6 p.m. and 7 p.m. Central Time. So let me talk a little bit about the FAFSA and why it is so important. The reason, one of the reasons why it's so important is that a lot of scholarships require you to have a FAFSA on file. So once you find out your EFC, which is your expected family, contribution, then that EFC is going to drive whether or not you're eligible for like financial aid. And regardless of what that number is, every school, pretty much every college, needs to have you to complete that. Whether your income is $50,000 a year or $150,000 a year or $1.5 million a year, if you're going to a college or university, you're going to have to fill it out. So, with that said, I want to encourage you to go ahead and fill the FAFSA out. Share this video on any page that you know of, put it in your text your friends, send it to them, and make sure that they're eligible because the sooner that you complete this, the sooner you'll know how much money that you're going to, or that number, that EFC. You will know if you're eligible or not for financial aid. And when you go to scholarships and they say financial need or something like that, if they specifically say that and you're not eligible for the Pell Grant or anything, you're not eligible. Don't waste your time and apply for that scholarship. However, it is important for you to make sure that you fill it out correctly. So, my son is Lawrence St. Christopher II. And so, if you have a junior or a third or something like that, a student that has a spelling a certain way, make sure that your Social Security card, the way that your student's name is on the Social Security card, is spelled out that exact same way. Because if you don't, what's going to happen is it's going to hold up the process. And in our circumstance, we had like a couple of applications that had two different spellings in them. So it just wasn't correct. It delayed everything. And you don't want anything delayed. In a pandemic like this, you want to be able to complete your information as early as possible because the early bird gets the worm. And one of the things we've seen, especially with historically Black colleges and universities, or HBCUs, is that there has been such an increase in individuals who are interested in supporting those schools based on like some of the diversity, equity, and inclusion initiatives, that there's going to be additional scholarship money that maybe we hadn't had before. And so if your student is thinking about going to HBCU, or they go to HBCU now, because again, they can get scholarships as freshmen, sophomores. One of the ladies in our classes this morning in our scholarship Saturday, she has a freshman who's attending an HBCU, and we found multiple scholarships that she was applicable for. So I want you to know that one, it's very important to complete your FAFSA, no matter what your income level is. Once you do it, make sure that you subscribe to our channel, like this video, and put the comment below so that you can be eligible for the $25 Amazon gift card. And then three, ensure that you have that Social Security card number to be, or to Social Security, your name on the Social Security card, to exactly the same way it is. And my grandfather clock is going off right now. I hope you all can still hear me. So I think those were the things that I wanted to share with you on this. The other thing is that if you missed today's Scholarship Saturday, we're going to have another one on October the 24th, which is a Saturday from noon to 1 p.m. Central Standard Time, US Central Standard Time. And so if you have a high school senior who is graduating in the class of 2021, or if you have a current college student that is in college, whether they're on their undergraduate degree or their master's program, there are scholarships available, and we will be going over those scholarships. So if you are interested, email me at lili@collegeboundvillage.org, and I'll put that below, and I will give you the rest of the details then. So I hope you found this video to be valuable. I would encourage you to share it with your friends. I want you to know we're also going to have a CBV Spirit Day coming up, because we're going to celebrate the spirit of CBV. We have people who are in our Facebook group, the College Bound Village, people who are following us on Instagram. We are almost at 900 Instagram followers. We have individuals who are part of our weekly email list, because we send us a Sunday email. And so we have all these people, and I want to bring them together so we can celebrate the village. And then we have, of course, our YouTube subscribers. So we are so excited about being able to help each student. We are so excited about being able to have this collective group of people who are working together and sharing information. And then this is going to make all of us prosper. So the generational wealth gap that we're talking about, can you imagine what a $100,000 scholarship, a 4-year full $100,000 scholarship to a state school, what impact that would have to a family? But think about even a private school that is a total of $300,000 for 4 years. You know, I attended Washington University in St. Louis, and of course, when I went, that tuition was not that way. But there are some schools that the tuition is just that much. And last year, we had a student in the College Bound Village who got the John Irvin Scholarship. And we've had multiple students who have had full ride scholarships or partial scholarships. They've had student loan debt in college that has been canceled as a result of connecting with the village. So I would just encourage you to just really try to connect with us and to continue to support us. And this is Silver Lining Lily signing off. I hope you guys have a great weekend and enjoy your family. And thanks again. Let's get this money for college. Bye-bye.